kati nkweveko nituambile nchito ifintu byali chinjire waliambilo kumoneka wino na bantu bale kukumbwa ati kwati tehulia wine twaishire abano bena bonsepe.
Mark, sometimes whenever I see you doing some stuff for the people who are in need, I try to look at you, I admire you, you know that?
Well, thank you.
I don't know why you'd like to do things like that.
I think it's important to give back. We've all been blessed so much, the fact that we're able to come to work, we have a job, we live in the country we live in, that we're able to do what we do, and it's really important to give back.
Well, that's great. Actually, you know, I'm so excited to speak to Mark Yando. Mark Yando is the director of registration and client services, client operations at Mary Fritz Transportation. How did you guys get involved into the Georgia Special Olympics?
I used to teach special ed kids in public school prior to coming to AmeriFleet. And when the Special Olympics approached me about needing some help, I went to our senior management and asked that they sponsor. And from the sponsoring of one event, we were able to get involved with their award ceremony and how they signed people up. And I came back and I said, you know, we need to do a golf tournament because a golf tournament raises a lot of money and we can really sponsor a lot that way. And that it kind of grew from there.
This organization, the Special Olympics, was started way back in 1968 by UNICEF's Kenneth Shriver, and it's going up to now.
Yes.
Is this like in every country or what?
Yes.
It's like it's about in about 150 countries?
I think it is 150 countries.
How do you guys manage? How do they do it, really?
Well, it's a huge internet. Each different state, for instance, in the United States, has their own Special Olympics organization, but they're all tied to the National Olympics. So in the state of Georgia, we help about 23,000 intellectually and physically handicapped people. And then from there, they participate in the games here in summer and winter games. And they can go from here, they go to national games. And national games would be where each state participates within the United States. And then they go to international games after that, where they participate across the world with all the other countries that are involved, much like the regular Olympics.
Oh, wow, that's very interesting. That should be a lot of work.
It is a lot of work.
Yeah. But I'm wondering, how did AmeriFreight Transportation get involved? Did you advise them to do that? Did you study it up after you had gone through what you had gone through?
I was fortunate enough to be involved with an award ceremony where after the games every summer, they do an award ceremony for all the participants. They acknowledge an outstanding coach, an outstanding volunteer, outstanding athletes. Through that award ceremony, they also acknowledge large fundraisers. I realized that the majority of the large fundraising came through people that had golf tournaments and got local participation as well as their industry to participate in raising funds. So I came back and I said, this is what we got to do. I didn't know anything about golf. When we first did our golf tournament and somebody said something about a birdie, all I knew is that they had feathers. But I learned a lot.
When you say children or people with special needs, what do you mean?
There is actually some criteria. They do a screening of IQ. Okay. And the IQ has to be below a certain level. So there's a learning disability need there. There's also any type of physical disability. So if you are in a wheelchair because you've got some problems with your legs or your spine, there's spinal bifida kids, there's people that are have cerebral palsy. There's a lot of different folks that participate. One of the greatest things, though, with the Special Olympics is everybody is a winner. Everybody's equal. And nobody gets put out of participation because of some certain criteria. There's a place for everybody to be there.
Is there an age limit or what?
No, there is no age limit. When I was teaching special ed kids, we started participating in Special Olympics locally inside the county with kindergarten age kids. You can be in Special Olympics all the way until, you know, you're a grandpa and beyond.
The golf tournament itself, you say, you've been doing it for the last 4 years, right? Mm-hmm. When are you going to have this tournament this year?
This year's golf tournament is May 3rd at Laurel Springs.
Okay.
It's a golf club in Alpharetta. And it's open to anybody that wants to sign up. They just go to AmerifleetGolf.com, www.AmerifleetGolf.com, and register. All the money that we raise through the golf tournament goes directly back to the Special Olympics. And that way we're able to sponsor this year in the Summer Games. This is our fifth year sponsoring the Victory Dance. The Victory Dance is a dance that they have on Sunday night, or Saturday night, I'm sorry. After all the games, all the athletes and the volunteers and the coaches and the families and AmeriFleet goes and we decorate the gym at Emory University, have a DJ, have drinks and snacks, and just dance and have a good time and celebrate that we're all there for the same reason.
Well, is there like, a sponsorship level for somebody to get into this tournament?
Mm-hmm. There's different levels. You can sponsor as one player, two players, have a foursome. And with that, you can, for instance, one player could sponsor and it's $175 just to come play.
Okay.
If you want to come play and share information about your business or provide giveaways to the people that are participating, it's $200. And then we put your name in the literature that we print, and you get sponsorship on the banner and by the tee box. And, we recognize a lot of places.
A person like me who's, I know I'm going to start playing golf. I don't know how much does that equipment cost. Maybe I can get one. I'm gonna try to do that. But right now I can't play golf. I can play soccer, Mark.
So
what do I do if I can't play golf? What can I do? Can I make a special donation online?
How do I do it? Absolutely.
Or like my viewers here, how do they make a donation if they can never play golf?
They can go online to www.AmeriFleetGolf.com and just donate. And that's fantastic because then we can recognize you in all of our literature and on our online page. Or contact me, Matt Yandel, at AmeriFleet.com. It's MYANDELL at AmeriFleet.com. And I will get that signed up and get you registered as a donating participant.
Thanks. I think one of the things you can do as a viewer, when you go to mcdonaldshow.com, there'll be a link for you to make that donation. So what you need to do is just go to www.mcdonaldshow.com. AmeriFleet Transportation, what is it?
AmeriFleet Transportation, basically, we move fleet vehicles.
The drivers.
Mm-hmm.
What criteria do you use to get these drivers?
We do complete background checks, as well as drug and alcohol. We check fully, the full extent. If they have any type of driving infraction, any type of DUI, any type of criminal offense at all, they can't drive for us. Because we have to make sure that not only are we looking at making sure your asset is okay and that car is okay, but we also have a responsibility to the public. If we put one of our drivers in a car, we are putting them out on the road. And that means that everybody that they come in contact with has an opportunity to be hurt if we don't employ the right people.
Wow, that's good. How does DOT come in?
DOT regulations are federally set regulations about qualifications for a driver, how long they can be on the road, and what type of vehicles they can drive. AmeriFleet follows those guidelines for all the vehicles that we move. In the industry, a drive-away company only really has to follow those rules for certain types of vehicles. But AmeriFleet follows them for everything, passenger car to big tractor trailer, because that's how important safety is.
Mark Yandel with AmeriFleet Transportation. Well, Mark, thanks very much for coming on the show.
Thank you, McDonald.
Whenever you want to make a donation towards this very special project, please go to AmeriFleet.com or you can go to McDonaldShow.com. There'll be a link to this site where you can make the donation. You don't have to play golf. You can just be a person like me who plays soccer. I'm from Africa, definitely. That's my game. Thanks, Mike.
Thanks.
We'll see you next time. All right, thanks.
Kalisa wangoma Alice Shelesa wako.